turn your fleece blankets into a stylish cape or poncho. Keep watching and I will show you a no-sew version and a simple-sew version of how to achieve this stylish cape. So I picked out this super soft plush throw from Walmart, and I think it was about either $4 or $2. I think it was on the more expensive side, so let's say $4. And what you will need is definitely a fleece blanket or a plush throw, and you will need pins, scissors, and I have fabric weights just to help me weigh down the fabric so that it doesn't move around. So go ahead and fold your fabric in half the way I am doing here. And you will fold the second part in half again. So this is what your folded blanket should look like. Make sure everything is aligned and even. Now is a perfect time to put my fabric weight so that my fabric doesn't move around. So this measurement, 7 inches, is the back of my neck measurement, just the back of my neck. And I'll fold that in half and mark at the top of my folded blanket. So we have about 3.5 inches. And so that will be the cutout for my neck area. So I'm just pinning it down about 3 inches down. So it's 3.5 inches wide and 3 inches down. And I am leaving about an inch or half an inch so down where I will cut at the center of my fabric. So these are the pins that I'm just adding here. All right, so we are ready to cut, but pay attention, we are only cutting one layer of our folds. So if you don't have one layer of your fold, don't cut anything. Just make sure you have one layer and go ahead and cut all around where you pinned. So this is what it should look like. You can go ahead and take out your pins, and I'm just leaving the center pin there. And oh my gosh, look at all this fleece or whatever this stuff is. But yeah, that's what I had to deal with. So, all right, so you can go ahead and unfold your blanket at this point. I'm keeping the pin on the center of my neck area, and I will just align the front pieces, the two pieces that I cut out. And I will finish off cutting the neck area and the rest of the fabric. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Monday, the voice behind Monday's Threads. And I like to simplify sewing or provide easy sewing projects. So if that is you, be sure to like and subscribe. Here we go with this lint, fleece, whatever this stuff is. This was so annoying. But guess what? This is really the end of the no-sew tutorial. So I just tried it on to see how it looks. And so if you have no sewing skill, this is it. You can still wear your poncho, your cape as is. I will definitely suggest freight checks so that we can have that lint or fleece or whatever it is in check. So if you are doing the sew version, you will need extra wide double fold bias tape and anything that is going to match your blanket, cape, or poncho. And this is the one that I'm using, and you will definitely need some pins as well. Get your double folded bias tape, and we will be sandwiching our blanket through the fold of our bias tape. Pin that down so it is nice and secure. We will do that for the whole area that we cut out. Once done, I'm just going to the edges and folding that in and then folding and pinning it down again. All right, so now we are ready to sew. You want to make sure that you have a new needle or a sharp needle because there's a bit of bulk to this. But if you can do a straight stitch, that's all we're going to be doing. And make sure that your throw, your blanket is sandwiched in so that as you sew, it stays secure in your stitches. If you haven't done it right, you're going to see your blanket coming out and your bias tape on the other side, and we don't want that. So take your time, make sure that the blanket is nicely sandwiched in. And guess what? We are done. All that's left is for you to style your DIY blanket poncho. Give this video a like and subscribe if you haven't. And let me know in the comments if this is something that you will try making. All right, guys, I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.
Here's not here.